She's an expert linguist and historian.
Agent 3, she's a criminal. What's worse, a traitor. She captured and imprisoned you, remember?
No, I don't. That memory was erased. But she did give herself up to give us this chance. Put her under house arrest. Do whatever you have to do, but bring her back. We need her.
I can't do this alone.
Very well. I'll release her. But if she slips up once, she's history.
I think she might surprise you. I'll be back when I find another of the artifacts.
You should know. The Cathalas have entered symbiotry space. They are ignoring all other planets and continuing towards Earth. It is doubtful the symbiotry defenses will slow them. Time is now our enemy.
Now I'm sure you're the only employee here. You're like a night watchman named Pops who comes around once in a while with a big ring of keys to make sure all the shiny metal things here still beep and look pretty. That door might be a trap. Door.
Eagle, pull the first lever.
The first description of Atlantis in literature was from Plato in a series of discussions from his works Timaeus and Critias. According to Plato, Atlantis was a utopia that existed somewhere in the Western Ocean. It was never known whether Plato was actually describing the fabled lost continent or fabricating an elaborate concept to help prove an argument, as he was known to do. Those large earthenware containers strewn about the docks are called pithoi. Bronze Age Mediterranean cultures used them to hold liquids like oil and wine. When full, they would be incredibly heavy, which is why I assume they have the lip. So, it would... I'm fairly certain that the dock ship is of Egyptian make. What would it be doing here, so far from home?
Avast, ye landlubbers! Ye face Arthur the Terrible and Blackwood the... mildly terrible, but still righteous mom! Strike ye colors and prepare to be bombed!
Dude.
He's a cagey fellow, but I guess being locked up will do that. Still, he seems to be waiting for someone in particular.
Captain's log, stardate 1262 BC. On a routine expedition, we've stumbled upon a strange Atlantean vessel with no crew. I'm hoping to rescue a naive alien mermaid shackled within the brig of this ship.
It almost looks like he's waiting for a passenger. The guy is some sort of ferryman. Well, when in Atlantis, do as the Atlanteans do, I suppose. And just for kicks, I'll add looks like nasty weather to your dialogue repertoire as a greeting. Although Atlantis is often thought of as a Greek civilization, there were many anthropologists who believed that Atlantis actually was derived from the Minoan civilization. Many huge terracotta pots like those pithoi were uncovered in the excavation of Knossos, the Minoan capital on Crete. Many of them ranged up to 9 feet tall and 6 feet in diameter. It's amazing they could turn pots that large, let alone fire them. All those handles were to distribute the weight over multiple...
Looks like... I must... Yeah. Yeah. So. No. The wind. Yeah. So what else? Looks like Padro's left to fulfill his part of the underground's plan. And it also looks like he left his bowl. The olive oil. Oh. Normally, Gage, I would tell you not to touch anything while you're in a store, but you're older now. Go ahead, play with the machine. Minoan artists were renowned in their day for their unique skill. They rejected the notion of rigid geometry in their work, creating beautiful art pieces that emphasized natural scenes.
Well, there's me olive oil.
Those vases have some sort of imprint on the front. They could represent the contents or who they belong to. The double axe was the holiest symbol to the Minoans. Religious axes were used by priests to kill sacrificial bulls for their beloved earth goddess. that oven looks interesting. Go poke your head inside and see if anything's cooking. That smells like breakfast.
If I knew you were coming, I would bake a cake and learn to sing. Stop me, Gage.